start off with these two rings. If this ring represented me, if you wanted to just draw a Venn diagram that was me, and do that with a circle. Everything inside the circle is me, and everything outside the circle is not me. It's everything else in my environment right now. You're all outside the circle, and I'm inside the circle. And as the evening wears on, if you can imagine yourself with a circle and mine, we'll certainly begin to overlap. There'll be some things that we know about each other that will be sort of in this common ground, and there'll be some things that you don't know about me and will never know about me, or me about you. So if you took Elizabeth and I, for example, when we first met, started courting and all that sort of stuff, and you know, pretty soon that area gets bigger and bigger, and we've been in each other's presence for over a decade, almost 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So that common area, that common area has grown quite a bit. But there are still some things that she does not know about me, and I'm not sure what they are, but I'm positive, because we'll be driving down the road and I'll say something and she'll slap her knee and say, you know, you've never said that to me before. It'll be something about, you know, Chief, my dog, when I was growing up as a child, or whatever it might be. So there's always some things that are left to learn that we don't know about each other. And the more we can put in those common areas, the stronger our relationship is. And in some cases, when you grow that area, all of a sudden somebody will say, the other person might say, what's the phrase? Too much information?
You might.
You're telling me something I didn't want to know. And it's sort of an oops, and you kind of back off a little bit. We'll get into, in the last session that we do with you, inclusion, control, and openness, we'll get into a little bit more of a dialogue about what it's like to be so open with someone that they know all these things about you. And sometimes, especially when that happens in a work environment, when people work together a lot, they'll form this sort of open affection for one another, and all of a sudden, people are in an emotional attachment that they may not know what to do with in a workplace, or in other situations as well. So there's all kinds of room for too much, and there's all kinds of room still to grow that ProZone so we know enough about each other to be very productive, work well together, socialize well together. And what we're going to talk about for the rest of the evening is a piece of that culture. Last week, when we were here, our instructors talked a lot about what in the world is culture, what's cultural competency. It has everything in the world to do with the overlap in those circles, because we believe, to net it out very simply, culture is made up of a set of rules that allow us to be successful in our relationship, to be a part of a relationship. Just a set of rules in the bottom line, a set of norms, whatever you want to call it. And one of the things that we know to be true is Elizabeth and I have a set of rules that we can live with in order to be successful in our relationship, and it's probably different than the set of rules that everybody else has in their relationship. But that's where culture resides in the relationship. And we talked a little bit about that last week. So, you going to talk about how to play spoons, or would you like to?